So this is where the proper LFS system is built. All these packages here form part of the all these packages in chapter 8 at least, and I think one or two, just Linux in chapter 10 form the final system that will be LFS. Everything we've built up to now has been temporary, purely to enable us to build all these packages in the correct manner. So installing basic system software, this is the basic system that we'll end up with all these packages. There's some information there about compiling. There's a bit there about the SPU value has been calculated using -J4. Some more information there about libraries. Bit there about package management. From an educational point of view, it's probably not necessary. Some people have asked about package management. I've never really seen the point myself, but if you want to extend Linux from scratch and have it update somehow, or even produce your own distribution, of which there are a few around based on Linux from scratch, then you might want to look into that, and it suggests different ways of managing the packages on this page. I've done this several times before. Once you've built a system, you can deploy it elsewhere onto systems with similar level of architecture or newer, and it just lists the files there that might need to be updated to reflect the new system. So things there like hosts, fstab, password group, network configuration, and so on. It says here there's been some reports of issues when copying between similar not identical architectures. For instance, the instruction set for an Intel is not identical to an AMD processor's instructions, and later versions, some processors may provide instructions that are available with early versions. So to me that's obvious, but obviously to some people that isn't so obvious. Basically, I wouldn't have said you could mix Intel and AMD, and you wouldn't expect something built for a certain processor to work for anything that came before that processor, but it should work for anything that comes after. So for example, if I built something for a Pentium, I would expect it to work on a Pentium 2, but not necessarily for an i486. In fact, almost certainly it wouldn't work for an i486. Likewise, if I built something for an AMD Athlon, I wouldn't expect it to work on an Intel chip. So you have to bear that in mind if you do want to replicate the Linux scratch system. So let's move on with the very first package. A nice couple of simple ones initially. The first one's man pages. Extract it, change into it. Looks like remove some crypt pages and then install the package. Looks like I need a new mouse. Okay, that's that done. And we move on to the next package, which I think is the smallest and certainly the quickest. And it's just a case of copying these two files into etc. And that's done. And then we move on to glibc. So we've got a couple of patches this time. And again, we'll create a build directory, change into it. Again, add some parameters to config params. Copy the configuration command. And then we build it, and this supposedly is going to take 11 SBUs, which in theory should be about 20 minutes or so. So we'll see how long it does take. 20 minutes on this system anyway. So let's start that running and come back when it's finished. Okay, that's built. So now we're going to run tests. And as it says, there's some tests may fail. They're not expected, but some tests are expected to fail on some packages. But these ones are known to fail for various reasons. As you can see, some of the reasons down the bottom of the page there. But this is part of the tool change libc, so it's considered critical. But I would advise to do tests for all the packages to just get a feel for how good the build is going. There isn't any real reason why anything should fail badly, apart from if a mistake has been made. Obviously, this process has been tested by the LFS team as they've been writing the book, so it should all work good. But it's nice to run the tests and be sure that what you've built is good to use. So make, check, and wait for this to complete. Okay, so that has finished, and we do have some errors as expected. In fact, we've only got one failure, 16 expected fails and 4 unexpected passes, so it's not a bad run actually. So it's just this IOTest L chmod, and that's known to fail in the LFS true environment, so basically that's all okay. So let's carry on with installing this. Create a file to prevent an error. And then run a fix. And install the package. Right, I'm going to have to get another mouse by the looks of it. Okay, and fix a path here, and copy configuration file. Let's just do this one at a time, and make a directory. Then it says install locales that can make the system respond to in a different language. None of the locales are required, but some of them are missing, so the test suites and some of the packages will skip important test cases. So what I'm going to do is run all of these in. You can run this single command in to install all the locales, but these are the ones that are needed to ensure best coverage of the tests. If you don't install these, then you've obviously got to expect that some tests will fail. Either case, whatever you add here, you might want to add in your own locale if it's not already there. For example, the two I normally enter are already here, so I won't be adding any extra in, but apart from that, these are the minimum required to cover all the tests. I'm going to copy them all in. I don't think they create any output at all. They do take a few seconds to run each one, so there'll be a bit of a pause while it goes through all of them, but I'm not expecting any failures running that lot in. There's also a bit here, it says you can use this locale def to create locales that are not listed in the supported file. There's two examples there. It does actually say, for instance, the following two locales are needed for some tests later in this chapter, so I don't think I've ever actually added these in, but things it says they're actually needed, I'll put these two in as well. Okay, now we need to create some configuration files and some time zone data. I'll do all the slots as one go. just check. There's no errors. No, that looks okay. Now determine the time zone we're in, so you can run this program. You just answer the questions. So I'm in Europe, and I'm in the UK, so that's number 8. And it tells me the time zone I need to use is Europe / London. So yes, it is, and it just confirms it again. But don't do the command it's got there. We make this a bit more permanent by running this command in here, and just change the XXX for the output of this command here without the quotes, so just the Europe London bit, press enter, and you can see a symlink's been created to that file, or from that file to ETC local time. Configuring the dynamic loader, copy that in, and there's an additional path here which is probably worth adding in. And that's glibc done.